Now that you've gotten an introduction to the marine mammals that live in the Salish Sea, we are going to start talking about some of the hazards to these marine mammals. The biggest threats to marine mammals are caused by humans. There are five main threats that humans cause. One, humans intentionally harming marine animals. Two, entanglement in fishing gear. Three, contaminants. Four, garbage such as plastics contaminating the Salish Sea. And five, stranding. A stranding is when a marine mammal is unable to return to its marine waters. Some stranded marine mammals are already dead. Some are still alive and can be helped. Each year, harbor seals and sea lions are shot. People shoot marine mammals because they think they are eating up all the salmon. The science facts are that seals and sea lions eat the fish that eat juvenile salmon. So they're actually helping the salmon by reducing their predators. Every year, we see more whales entangled in fishing gear. It is very hard to get a whale disentangled, but there are a few people who are trained to do this. To disentangle a whale, you have to have a lot of training. It is not something that just anyone can do. It can be very dangerous. One of the ways toxins can get into the marine waters is from runoff. Once in the water, they eventually make their way into the food web. They affect all marine mammals. Bioaccumulation is when a substance is taken in faster than it is used or excreted. Biomagnification occurs when these effects are amplified up the food chain. For example, zooplankton will take in a small number of toxins, but it's still faster than they excrete them, so they are bioaccumulated. Since fish eat a lot of zooplankton, they accumulate the toxins even faster, since they're taking them in from each zooplankton they eat. At the top of the food chain, like with orcas, there are even higher numbers of toxins. We find toxins in all marine mammals that are deceased. Plastics and garbage that wind up in the marine environment are often called marine debris. They are carried by waterways, the wind, or careless people leaving garbage on the beach or throwing it overboard from their boats. We see a lot of marine mammals that get entangled in plastic like this. The animal gets plastic ring around its neck, and as it grows bigger, the plastic eventually can choke it. There are a lot of ways that you can help so that our beaches don't look like the one in this picture. One thing you can do is reduce the number of single-use plastics you use. You can do this by replacing single-use plastic items, like water bottles, with reusable alternatives. Anytime you are done with plastic items, you should make sure they are properly recycled. You can also participate in beach cleanups to help remove the debris from your beach. The next time you go for a walk, you can bring a bag with you to clean up any trash you might find. If you see a marine mammal in distress, be sure to call the Whatcom Marine Mammal Stranding Network at 360-966-8845.